Now I would like to invite Mr. Vasily Lapin to present his paper, An Implicative Criterion of Fracture Growth Direction for 3D Simulation of Hydraulic Fracture Propagation.
Thanks to Professor Volosevic for introducing me. Good afternoon to everyone. It's an honor for me to make presentation here. I would like to describe the progress of development of 3D fracture, hydraulic fracture model, and in particular I will talk about the fracture growth criterion that we relate with the conference. This is outline of my presentation. I will speak about 20 slides, so everyone may be different. I will talk about why, what, and how. The criterion is going to be used in scope of 3D hydraulic fracture model. It consists of flow propagation model, fracture propagation is expressed in the fluid flow, and everything is connected, collected together with iterations. Why we are focused on the fracture propagation? Because we would like to predict the fracture trajectory, and it's important for fracture because of curvature fracture, the pinching may occur and the whole process can stop. What do I mean when I talk about implicit or explicit criteria? Everyone knows explicit criteria, like strain energy density and so on. We look at the fracture, calculate strain density factor, look at the implicitly small vicinity of the fracture, and maximize or minimize something that depends on stress intensity in this vicinity. A few years ago, implicit criteria has been proposed. The idea is not to look at the stress state before the fracture propagates, but on the stress state after the fracture propagates. And the authors, with some little magic, can obtain the stress intensity factor at this point. And after that, they minimize or maximize something that connected with this, this point. Unfortunately, they need to simplify the problem because an analytical solution is always difficult. But hydraulic fraction is always cannot be simplified except the one-dimensional problem. So we decided to calculate this stress intensity factor numerically. We propagate the fracture anywhere, calculate stress intensity factor, and find the point where the stress intensity factor is minimum or maximum, it doesn't matter. Everyone knows about three models of stress intensity factors. I just want to stress that in 3D we have two angles, two parameters that gives us the front in direction, and I want to stress that all points of the front are connected. If you move one front, then you change the twist angle of the neighbor's points. We need to state something to minimize or maximize something, and we based on the principle of symmetry by Costin-Salganik, we want fracture to propagate in the direction where two models are zero, and we have two angles to reach this, but unfortunately these angles are connected together, so we have only one variable and two conditions. It's impossible to solve these conditions, to satisfy them both simultaneously, so we use slightly a weak formulation and want to minimize integral of sum, sum of two transitants the factor along the front. We use iteration because we are numerical scientists. Suppose that at each iteration we have to find the variation of the kink angle. Twist angle can be expressed in terms of kink angle, and we assume that stress intensity factor also can be expressed as a minimum function of kink angle. It is possible at each iteration, but it's not true for everything. So we have to solve linear. System of linear equation at each iteration, and if we if this iteration converge, we have the condition for minimum and maximum of this function. How many iterations do we need to list the convergence? Likely, it's not necessary to make a lot of iterations if we find appropriate parameters. For example, I will talk further. Five iterations is enough because the variation is about 1 to 10% and as you can see, the second norm is quite small. What's the problem? The problem is the weight parameter. This beta. If we vary the parameter, we vary the trajectory, but we want to predict the trajectory. It's a simple problem about penny-shaped fracture implied in the rock that is stressed by not uniform stresses. We have tried to find this parameter from analytical criterion, but different analytical criteria gives us different values. So we decided to calibrate it using the experiment. Following the previous scientists who proposed the implicit criteria, we use unplanned fraction in simple 3.1. We have varied two parameters and analyze the kink angle and the first step on fraction trajectory. Yes, there Lazarus does. Also, we compared with the explicit criteria, it's Erdogan C and Sherman criteria, based on maximum tensile stress and implicit criteria of Lazarus. Here, the stress intensity factor of the first inclined fraction. There are some discrepancies in our prediction. And here the distribution of kink angle, red first line and blue, green second is the expressed criteria obtained by us and by Lazarus, and the third is the implicit criteria of Lazarus, and fourth is the implicit criteria of our expressed criteria. It is close to the experiment distribution. We have two parameters, fracture increment and weight parameter beta. We have varied both of them and hoped to find the best values of each parameter. But unfortunately, we obtained only dependence of weight parameter of fracture increment. For each fracture increment, we can find beta to obtain the mentioned with experiment. Following the Lazarus, following the previous authors, we have taken the fracture increment from the experiment. We suppose that it's equal to two facets. And obtain the best mentioned for beta 0. You can see that really matches the experiment. It's the first experiment that I have. This is dependence I have. We're not satisfied with the result. I felt so why. So we decided to focus on deflection trajectory. It is difficult to compare 3D surfaces using 2D presentation. So I will talk about trajectory, means the intersection of flat surface and the free surface of the sample. Our calculation is calculation for another. For each beta, we have varied the fraction increment, and suppose that the less fraction increment, the more exact trajectory we have obtained. And for the ideal or trajectory obtained for the lowest fraction increment is the same for all. For all weight parameters, it can be named ideal or exact. And it's the same for all parameters. And the most stable trajectory, the most is obtained for us beta 0. We increase the fraction increment, but trajectory is stable. Except this value, but this value is compared with the size of the sample. And the result is that beta 0 is the best value from the point of view first step and from the point of view fraction trajectory, and everything is okay, it seems to be okay. But beta 0 means that the stress intensity factor third order is not taken into account at all. We have used the same experiment that various scientists used to evaluate their implicit criterion and obtained that the third model shouldn't be taken into account. It sounds surprising, so we decided to try other experiments. But unfortunately, we haven't finished the research about this experiment in the conference. So the question is still open, why it's so, why the best match of this experiment is obtained with third order of stress that this factor is not taken into account. That's all that I wanted to say and to discuss. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Lapin, for your nice presentation.